Hi, I'm Carley Fox, and I'm an ordinary Hoosier. I want to be an art therapist, and I'm going to Heron School of Art. And right now, I'm very interested in art and doing a lot of art projects. I like 3D art because it's more hands-on, and I'm not a very good drawer at all. I'm really good at just making designs out of nowhere. I'm not sure where it comes from, but and it's really therapeutic for you whenever you're doing hands-on stuff with clay or Play-Doh for like young kids. And I think that's why I like it so much, is the therapeutic part of it. I was hospitalized 2 years ago due to a self-inflicted gunshot wound. And I worked with an art therapist there. And that's when I really started my love for art. And it kind of gave me something to do other than be sad and stuff. 5 years ago, I lost my cousin, who was my best friend. And he drowned in Terrace Lake. I fell into a depression my eighth grade year during that. And then my sophomore year of high school, I got mono, and I lost a lot of friends. I lost a then boyfriend. It put me in even more of a depression than I already was, and I couldn't go to school. I was going half days, and I was stuck in my room most of the time. Nobody wanted to come see me because I was sick with mono. I was put on a medication that was meant for adults. It put even worse thoughts in my head, and then that's when finally I was like, I'm done with this. I went to school and it was a normal day. I woke up and I was fine, but I still had the depression thoughts in the back of my head. Me and my friend, we went to lunch. We actually skipped a class. And then we came home. She dropped me off at my house and she lives right over a couple streets away. I was getting ready for work and I laid down and I was just like, I'm really just over everything. But I remember talking to one person and it was my friend, and I texted her and I was like, I just want you to know I love you, and make sure that, you know, everybody else knows that I love them, that you know is important to me. And then I went into my brother's room and I had his gun and I shot myself, and she came running in, and her and my ex-boyfriend then, they were the ones that saved my life. I shot myself right here in my shoulder heart area, but I was shaking so much that it was there, and they had to take an artery from my leg and put it up there, and it was an emergency surgery. I think that my recovery started probably the middle of my junior year, when I finally had all of my medication lined out and I was stable and I could be alone at home. And I think that's when I was like, I want to help people. I've talked with people and have helped them through that time, and it actually got them through it. And sometimes I never talk to them again. They're good from then on out. But then some people I have made a friendship with, and they are like, if you can make it through all of that, then I can. You know, coming from the bottom, starting all over again. People are always telling me, they're like, why do you talk about it so like it's nothing? And I'm like, because I want to spread the word and make it known that people can get through this. And people are always so appalled that I'm so open about everything. Somebody has to be open about this stuff, because there are other people thinking it. It's not just me. My passion to help people comes from me needing help at one point in my life, and I've had family members that have needed help, and everybody needs help once in their life. People say they don't, but they really do, deep down inside. things do happen for a reason, and God obviously kept me here for a reason, and so I think that reason is to help other people. I love that I can be myself in my life right now, and that I have so many supporters, my family and friends. I'm excited that I've gotten this far and that I can say that I went through that, and I want to help people that go through the same problems. I can't believe that I'm actually graduating. There is hope out there, and don't give up on it. It might seem like it's the end, but it's not, and there's light at the end of the tunnel.